So you think an EV might be right for you. Many shoppers aren't sure where to start when considering an EV, and there's a lot to consider. Let me walk through some of the basics of the big topics: charging, range, and how EVs drive compared to gas-powered vehicles. When shopping for a traditional gas car, you don't have to consider how quickly the gasoline flows out of the pump or how quickly your car can accept the gasoline, but those are important things for EVs. One of the most important things to know is how long it will take to charge, and the answer is it depends. How much time it takes to charge an EV and how many miles of range that adds depends on a lot of factors, including the battery size, the vehicle's overall efficiency, the air temperature, the vehicle's onboard charger, and the capability of both the home or public charger you're using, as well as the electrical circuit that feeds it. That's a lot. Charging an EV could take anywhere from 20 minutes to 40 hours or more due to a lot of factors. While manufacturer charge time estimates are a decent starting point, recognize before you purchase an EV that those estimates are for the best case scenario. Your mileage may vary. Know that there are three levels of electric vehicle charging: level 1, level 2, and DC fast charging. Here's what all that means. A level 1 charging setup uses your standard 120-volt household outlet and should really be a last resort for an EV, because charging an electric car from a typical wall socket can literally take days. Level 2 charging setup uses a 240-volt circuit and is the fastest way to charge an EV at home. There are also public level 2 chargers often seen in parking garages or shopping malls. There are a lot of variables to this charging setup, including your charging hardware and the vehicle's capabilities. So a rough charging time estimate ranges from as little as 4 hours or up to as many as 15. Lastly, DC fast chargers found in public lots can vary considerably in maximum power delivery, but expect to spend about 20 minutes to one full hour. Better bring a book. Range anxiety is real. Nobody wants to run out of juice on the road. But how far can an EV go is not really the right question. Rather, ask how much range will you actually need? And that depends on a couple of things, namely how far you commonly drive, in what conditions, and what your access to public and home charging looks like. Most data suggests that the average driver travels less than 30 to 40 miles per day, and considering the average standard EPA estimated driving range of model year 2023 EVs is around 260 miles, the vast majority of EVs would get you where you need to go with range to spare. But you'll need to factor in a few things to get a more accurate range estimate. First, EVs can lose about 40% of their range when temperature drops from 75 to 20 degrees Fahrenheit due to battery sensitivity to temperature and the extra energy consumption from needing to heat the cabin. Remember, there's no hot gas engine burning fuel to generate heat for the car. That energy has to come from the battery. Simply put, if you drive in cold temperatures, you're going to have less range. For example, an EV with a rated range of 250 miles could have only 150 miles of range when it's just 20 degrees outside. Next, just like your cell phone battery, as your EV battery ages, it loses capacity. Some studies show EV batteries lose 5 to 10% of overall capacity over the span of 5 years. So the worst case scenario is that the 250 mile range we started with might only get you about 125 miles in very cold weather after 5 years of ownership. Last, automakers recommend that you regularly charge the battery only to 80 or 90% and try not to drop below 10% to extend its life. A full 100% charge is only recommended for longer trips. That means you're immediately cutting the range by up to 30% for daily use if you want maximum battery life. How EVs drive is an important consideration. The driving experience is different from gas-powered cars in a couple of key ways. The best way they differ is in the immediacy of power. You don't need to buy an expensive EV sports car to feel this effect. Even the cheapest electric cars feel super quick. That's because an electric motor makes its maximum torque right off the line, so mashing the go pedal provides instant acceleration. There's also usually no traditional transmission, so there's no waiting for downshifting or the engine speed to climb to get more power like a gasoline-powered car. The result is often surprising quickness, even in a cheap EV. It can be a lot of fun. You might notice a difference on the stopping side of things as well. EVs use regenerative braking, which recaptures energy that would otherwise be lost during deceleration and feeds it back to the battery. Sometimes these systems feel natural, but more often than not, you're going to notice a difference. The brakes can have a non-linear feel and a more lurchy action than regular brakes. This is something that will take getting used to with time and experience, but eventually becomes a very natural part of the driving experience. Some EVs further maximize efficiency and smoothness through a one-pedal driving mode, where the accelerator pedal is used to accelerate and brake. As you ease up on the accelerator, the car engages its regenerative braking to aggressively slow the car without requiring the use of the brake pedal in normal driving. But you still have to use the brake pedal for heavier braking or in an emergency. Ever driven a golf cart? kind of feels like that, but you're going a lot faster. While EVs are quite different from gas-powered cars, you may find that one could slide into your life fairly easily, with the right amount of research and preparation. They're not going away. In fact, your choices are growing. There are more electric cars than ever before, and more are coming soon. So how much range do you really need? You can find out in our next episode of EV 101. And in the meantime, you can learn all about electric vehicles at cars.com/EV.